会去。
Evo, počet ćemo, ispričavam se na kašnjenju, gospođi Vandan je kasnio avion, a onda su organizatori odlučili malo i provest kroz sajam dok su još ljudi proizvođači tu, s obzirom koliko je ona zapravo bliska za same proizvođače hrane, to je razlog malo kašnjenja, ispričavamo se to ime. Moje ime je Dražen Šimleša i član sam udruge ZMAK koji je jedan od organizatora ovog cijelog foruma i evo, u to ime vas pozdravljam i daću samo kratki uvod u današnje predavanje doktorice Vandane Šive. Mislim da se svi možemo složiti i vaša brojnost tu govori o tome da je danas zaista izniman dan u Sisku i to ne samo za Sisak nego i za cijelu Hrvatsku. I evo, prije nego što počnemo, htio bih se zahvaliti našoj Sunčani i cijeloj ekipi iz MAG-a, Ireni, Andreji i lokalnoj ekipi iz Siska i posebno drugoj Ireni koja je zapravo zaslužna što je Vandana Šiva danas s nama tu. Zaista im evo velika hvala i evo možda jedan pljesak. Hvala zaista svima. Pošto je ovo, rekao sam, izniman dan za sve nas i imamo iznimnu gošću, ja nju ne bih predstavio tako da čitam stvari koje ovako i onako možete naći na internetu. To bi mi bilo nekako kao obezvređivanje cijelog današnjeg uzbuđenja. Nego ću evo malo možda i sebično, pošto sjedim tu, iskoristio ovu priliku da nas uvedem u cijelu priču kako sam se ja nekako upoznao sa radom Vandane Šiva prije mnogo, mnogo godina, što onda uzrokuje i ovu jednu lijepu pozitivnu tremu i uzbuđenje što je evo danas s nama tu. Kad zbrojimo sva njena dijela, knjige, sve što je pisalo, ja se sjećam da je mene knjiga Monokulture uma otvoreno da kažem razvalila i zaista utjecala na mene, jer mi u to doba kad sam je prvi put imao u rukama i čitao, bilo fascinantno da je netko toliko lijepo spojio da dok razmišljamo na monokulturan način, znači dok razmišljamo ograničeno i zarobljeno, ne možemo se drugačije niti odnositi niti prema prirodi, niti prema jednim drugima. I sustav koji promovira monokulture uma zapravo želi ograničiti, želi zarobiti, želi kontrolirati, želi prisvojiti i privatizirati ono što je zajedničko i što pripada svima. Vandana Šiva nas u svojom radu i rekao bi životu uči upravo drugačije. Znači uči nas kako da prigrlimo raznolikost, kako da je poštujemo, kako da je cijenimo, kako da shvatimo principe po kojima funkcionira i kako da shvatimo da smo svi dio tog jednog sustava. I to promovira u svom životu neovisno da li govori o sjemenu, malim seljacima i proizvođačima hrane, ženama, lokalnim kulturama i zajednicama i čitavog svijeta. No ono što mislim da je najvažnije da je svjesna što riječi i knjige, ako su prazne, ne ostavljaju takav trag na nama i ona nije samo osoba koja piše knjige, ona je i osoba koja je na terenu, ona je aktivistica i ona se zapravo zajedno bori i živi svoja djela i mislim da je to jedan razlog zašto je 1993. dobila nešto što se naziva alternativna Nobelova nagrada za mir, znači Right Livelihood Award. Njena zadnja knjiga, samostalna, autorska, nas poziva da postignemo mir sa planetom Zemlja i ovo nam je zaista jedna iznimna prilika da s njom uživamo na tom putu dok je s nama tu.
Hvala.
It's a joy to make my first trip to Croatia. Dobar dan. And in the word dobar dan is dan, which is very significant in our language.
Riječ dan, koja je dio riječi, dio pozdrava dobar dan, ima vrlo veliko značenje u našem jeziku.
Dan, when pronounced as dhan, means the seed.
Kada ga na ovaj način izgovorimo, to znači sjeme.
And that's why I started Navdanya, nine seeds for diversity, because after nine, you go to one and zero. 10 becomes one and zero. You can't go beyond nine.
Zato sam i započela svoj rad sa Navdanijom, devet zrna, devet sjemena, jer nakon broja devet dolazi ponovno broj jedan, deset, jedan i nula.
And the significance of the nine and the nine seeds was given to me by a tribal farmer to whom I had gone to collect seeds.
Značaj broja devet povezanog u sjemenje naučila sam od jednog lokalnog proizvođača, poljoprivrednika, kod koga sam došla kupiti sjemenje.
I had looked at chemical agriculture, industrial agriculture, and realized that the monoculture of the mind was making us believe that we were producing more when we were destroying the potential of nature to give us diversity in food.
Proučavala sam uzgoj hrane uz pomoć kemikalija i ustanovila sam da to upravo dovodi do monokulture uma koja nam
destroys, even though it pretends to produce.
Koje zapravo razara, iako želim da vjerujemo da proizvodi i stvara više.
And so I celebrate diversity, the diversity of plants in this decoration.
Ja slavim i pozdravljam raznovrsnost, kao na primjer bilje u ovom ukrasu na stolu.
The diversity of languages, Croatian that is so different, I don't understand it, but also has a little sound of our language, Hindi, Sanskrit.
Volim raznolikost u jezicima također, hrvatski koji je tako različit, ipak ima neki prizvuk našeg jezika, Sanskrita.
So I go to this farmer and he is growing nine crops together in his little field.
Dakle, odlazim u posjetu ovom poljoprivredniku, on uzgaja devet biljaka na istom mjestu, na svom polju.
It's a little farmer in a very remote region where it took me about 8 hours to reach after landing in Bangalore.
To je jedan jako, jako mali proizvođač koji živi u tako udaljenom području da mi je bilo potrebno nakon dolaska u Bangalore 8 sati da dođem do njega.
So I said to him, you're growing nine crops. And he said, yes, Navdani.
Rekla sam mu, dakle, vi uzgajate devet biljaka, a on je rekao, da, Navdani.
But then he gave me a discourse on cosmology that even doctorates and universities can't give.
Zatim je održao pravo predavanje o kozmologiji koje bi mogli, recimo, profesori i doktori na sveučilištu predavati.
He said, the nine seeds in my field reflect the nine planets in the universe.
Rekao je, devet vrsti sjemena u mojem polju odražavaju devet planeta.
And they reflect the diversity that our body needs to stay healthy.
A također oslikavaju i raznovrsnost koja je potrebna našem tijelu kako bi ostalo zdravo.
So when I grow the nine seeds, I'm taking care of the universe, the land and my own health.
Stoga, ako uzgajam i sijem devet vrsti sjemenja, istovremeno vodim brigu o svom zdravlju, o svemiru i o planeti.
And that's exactly what all the people who have brought their stalls and their wonderful products are producing. Diversity and health.
To je upravo to što su ljudi koje sam sada susrela na sajmu što čine. Dakle, oni kreiraju raznovrsnost i omogućuju nam zdravlje.
But there's another meaning to dan, and that is the gift.
Dan ima još jedno značenje, a to je dar.
When we share and we give gifts to each other and thank you, it's a to the seed saver who gave me this gift of seed. No seed saver ever says, this is my property. You have to pay me a royalty.
Proizvođači sjemenja poklanjaju jednim drugima sjeme, kao što sam ja dobila ovo sjemenje, i oni nikada ne kažu, ovo je moje vlasništvo i želim da mi se plaćaju tantijeme, profit.
You have lived through first wars that fragmented a unified country and then an economic war that stole the collective wealth of the people.
Proživjeli ste razdoblje gdje je rat fizički razorio jednu zemlju, ali i ekonomski, gdje je zajedničko bogatstvo, zajedničko vlasništvo razdobljeno.
There is a very strange thinking that is being used to privatize this planet.
Postoji jedna ideja u pozadini takvih događanja da se to čini kako bi se spasila planeta.
And that thinking is false for three reasons.
To je lažno, netočno iz tri razloga.
And I woke up to this in 1987 when I was called to a meeting on the new genetic engineering, the new biotechnology.
To sam sama osvijestila 1997. godine kada sam bila pozvana na na sastanak o genetski modificiranom bilju.
And like we are discussing the future we must create out of all the disasters and all the exploitation, the industry was discussing how to take over the seed.
Dakle, to je bilo jedno razdoblje kada se nastojalo stvoriti, osmisliti budućnost nakon svih katastrofa koje su se događale. Kako osmisliti budućnost? Industrija je pri tome preuzela riječ.
And the industry that's taking over the seed is the same industry that brought us the poisons, the pesticides, the chemicals.
Industrija koja se bavi prodajem takvog sjemenja je ona ista industrija koja je na tržištu prodavala pesticide i otrove.
Pesticides and chemical fertilizers are less than 100 years old.
Pesticide i kemijsko gnojivo stari su manje od 100 godina.
They started in Hitler's labs.
A započelo se sa njima u Hitlerovom laboratoriju.
The same factories that were making explosives also started to make nitrogen fertilizer.
Iste tvornice koje su proizvodile oružje, proizvodile su i dušično gnojivo.
Even though this bean, when we grow it, it can fix the nitrogen for free for us.
Iako ovo zrno graha, kada ga posijemo, nam pruža dovoljno dušika, i to besplatno.
But there was an illusion created that if the factories don't provide nitrogen, there's no way our soil will have nitrogen.
Međutim, stvorena je određena iluzija da ukoliko tvornice ne omoguće proizvodnju dušika, da nije moguće da zemlja to sama stvori.
And all the pesticides grew out of the early poison gases and gases used to kill people.
Pesticidi su nastali u istom procesu u kojem su nastajali otrovi za ubijanje u ratu.
So, chemical agriculture has its beginnings in war.
Kemijski potpomognuta poljoprivreda ima svoje ishodište u ratu.
And it continues the war through our food system.
A i nastavlja ratovati kroz naš sustav prehrane.
The first is the war against diversity, because chemical agriculture can only exist as a monoculture.
Prvi rat koji vode je rat protiv raznolikosti, zato što oni promoviraju, oni jedino kemijski potpomognuta poljoprivreda može opstati u monokulturi.
But it doesn't just destroy the diversity of plants, it destroys the diversity of our pollinators, without which we wouldn't have food.
Ona ne samo da uništava raznovrsnost u bilju, nego i u kukcima. kupcima koji oplođuju bilje i bez kojega se ništa se ne može dobiti proizvodnju.
Or the soil organisms without which there would be no food either, because they are the real producers of soil fertility.
Oni doista biljke stvaraju, obogaćuju zemlju i čine je plodniju.
The thing about war and a war mentality is you don't have to know what you're destroying.
Stvar koja je karakteristična za rat i mentaliteta povezanog sa ratom je da ne moraš uopće poznavati ono što uništavaš.
Peace and love require compassion, and that means compassion, to know the other and welcome another species, another person.
Zahtijevaju suosjećanje, a ono ne može, ono se ne može ostvariti bez poznavanja drugog čovjeka ili, ili druge vrste.
So there's a war against all of the potential of the earth and people to create and produce.
Odvija se rat protiv ne samo ljudi, nego i sve svog stvaranja na svijetu koje je sada prisutno.
In my assessment, industrial agriculture on a world scale, which has been pushed even further with globalization and the neoliberal model, it has destroyed 75% of this planet.
U mojoj studiji u kojoj sam proučavala industrijsku proizvodnju, industrijsku poljoprivredu, ustanovila sam da je 75% planeta već uništeno.
75% of the water, soil and the biodiversity.
75% vode, tla i bioraznolikosti.
And now we have such an unstable climate. I was told you had floods last year. In my region we had floods. That I come from the Himalaya, 20,000 people were washed away.
Kao posljedica su promjene, su klimatske promjene, rečeno mi je da ste prošle godine imali poplavu u području, himalajskom području od kud ja dolazim, poplava je ubila 20,000 ljudi.
And I wrote a book called Soil Not Oil, in which I calculated that 40% of the pollution, of the emissions that's changing our climate through the greenhouse effect, come from industrial farming.
U knjizi koju pišem, Zemlja, a ne ulje, tumačim da je 40%
greenhouse gases, the pollution.
Da je 40% udio, dakle, plinova, stakleničkih plinova, doprinio ovim promjenama na Zemlji.
So one is carbon dioxide from too much fossil fuel. Second is nitrogen oxide from those nitrogen fertilizers. And third is methane from animals in prisons, factory farms.
Jedan od tih plinova je ugljični dioksid, za kojeg znamo da dolazi iz industrije i automobila. Zatim dušični nitrogen
oxide,
dušični oksid, kao posljedica gnojenja zemlje, a zatim to su i plinovi koji se stvaraju prilikom uzgoja stoke.
And when these unstable events, extreme events take place, the monoculture, agriculture, is destroyed more easily.
I kada dolazi do tih velikih promjena u prirodi, upravo monokultura prije će biti uništena.
We just had rains and hailstorms at harvest time. Farmers were getting ready to cut their wheat, and then these hailstorms destroy the crop.
Sada upravo u vrijeme žetve imali smo strašne oluje i žetva je bila uništena.
But the farmers who work with Navdanya said our crop stood because it was resilient, because they were using local seeds and doing organic.
Poljoprivrednici iz pokreta Navdanije rekli su da su njihove biljke odoljale tim vremenskim nepogodama zato što su bile vitalnije jer su uzgojene od tog domaćeg sjemena.
Local seeds have more taste, more health, more nutrition.
Domaće sjemenje je zdravije, hranjivije i bolje ukusi.
And it isn't that seed was invented by anybody.
Nitko nije izumio sjeme.
So, but the companies that had brought us the poisons now said, we will claim seed to be our invention so we can collect royalty and we can privatize the seed and make money out of poisons on the one hand and out of royalties for seed on the other.
I tvrtke koje su do sada prodavale otrove žele privatizirati sjemenje, kažu to je naše vlasništvo i mi imamo pravo na profit od njega. Dakle, truju na dva načina nas truju.
And that's the day I decided I would start saving seeds.
Tog dana odlučila sam da ću početi sakupljati sjeme.
And I want to really pay a tribute to all of you from this area who are saving every tiny seed.
I doista vam želim zahvaliti svima u ovom području koji je svako malo sjeme sačuvati.
Because there is no act bigger than the act of saving a small seed.
Ne postoji bolja reklama nego reklama čuvanja čak i malog najmanjeg sjemenja.
Because in that seed you're saving the potential for the future.
Jer u njemu se nalazi potencijal za budućnost.
You are saying no to the privatization of life.
Tada govorite, tada je vaš odgovor ne na privatizaciju života.
You are defending the culture of the dar, of the gift, of the exchange between people.
I branite kulturu dana, međusobnog razmjenjivanja i darivanja sjemena.
And through it you're also producing food, the most basic need.
A ujedno i proizvodite hranu koja je najosnovnija ljudska potreba.
And in terms of food, there is this pretension that you can substitute with artificial things the food that comes from the soil and from real seed.
Još jedna zabluda se nastoji kreirati da moramo obogatiti kemikalijama ono što je uzgojeno u prirodi.
We've seen the cancer epidemic grow in the world. Everywhere cancer because of those pesticides.
Svjedoci smo velikog porasta pojavnosti raka upravo zbog korištenja pesticida.
Genetic engineering only gives us two kinds of crops. One with a poison in it called the BT crop and another herbicide tolerant which can tolerate the company's own chemical in the case of Monsanto, Roundup.
Industrija proizvodi samo dvije vrste sjemena, jedno koje već u sebi sadrži otrov i drugo koje sadrži pesticide i koje je pomoću tih pesticida otporno na pesticide koje koristi tvornica koja ga je proizvela, kao u slučaju Monsanto.
Glyphosate is the chemical name, Roundup is the brand name.
Glyphosate is the name of the...
Glyphosat.
Je... naziv kemikalije.
And the trade name is Roundup.
Roundup je brand pod kojom se... marka pod kojom se prodaje.
The World Health Organization of the United Nations, about a month ago, said this is a possible carcinogen. It gives cancer.
Svjetska zdravstvena organizacija prije otprilike mjesec dana utvrdila je, objavila je u javnosti da je to mogući uzrok raka.
Argentina, which grows a lot of Roundup ready soja, wherever there is spraying of Roundup, people are getting cancer.
U Argentini koja puno koristi Roundup soju, u područjima gdje ljudi počinju uzgajati na taj način, počinju dobivati raka.
Latin American countries are joining up to say we've got to ban this.
Južno-latinoameričke zemlje organiziraju se kako bi napustile takvu praksu.
And
I think, zabranili.
And I think it would be so bold if the seed movement in this region was to also say Roundup, Roundup.
Bilo bi jako dobro i da uzgajivači sjemena, odnosno pokret uzgajivača sjemenja, u ovom području uspiju također zabraniti Roundup sjemena.
Because as our work in India has shown, the less chemicals we use, the more food we can grow.
Kao što se pokazalo u našoj praksi u Indiji, u čim manje kemikalija se koristi, uzgaja se više hrane.
The less chemicals we use, the healthier our communities.
Čim manje kemikalija koristimo, naša zajednica je zdravija.
You have been subjected to all kinds of wars.
Žrtve ste različitih vrsti rata.
But there's a big war against the farmers of my country.
U tijeku je jedan veliki rat protiv poljoprivrednika moje zemlje.
Because when you use your own seed and you work with the soil and increase the soil fertility and you grow diversity, you can grow food without any cost.
Ukoliko koristite svoje vlastito sjemenje, ukoliko uzgajate raznovrsno bilje, tada proizvodite hranu bez troška.
Otherwise, society couldn't have fed itself for 10,000 years.
Jer kako bi se inače čovečanstvo hranilo posljednjih 10,000 godina?
But because the companies want to sell these poisons and these seeds, they make it look like without buying these costly ingredients, we can't grow food.
Međutim, ove tvrtke koje uzgajaju kemikalije žele nas uvjeriti da bez njihovih kemikalija ne možemo uzgojiti dovoljno hrane.
When I started to save the seed, I was inspired by Gandhi, who was called the father of the nation because he led India's freedom movement.
Kad sam počela zakupljati sjemenje, bila sam nadahnuta Gandhijem, koji je inače započeo, kao što znamo, oslobodilački revoluciju u Indiji, kojeg smatramo ocem našeg naroda.
And the reason he came back from South Africa to join the movement was because at that time we used to be ruled and enslaved by the British. We were their colony.
Razlog zbog kojeg je došao, zbog kojeg se vratio iz Južne Afrike, bio je taj što u ono vrijeme smo bili porobljeni od Velike Britanije. Njihova kolonija smo bili.
India has produced the best textiles, but they used to make it illegal for us to make our own textiles.
Indija je poznata po proizvodnji tekstila, međutim u to vrijeme bilo je zabranjeno proizvoditi biljke u Indiji za proizvodnju tekstila.
So that they could make the cloth in the mills in England.
Tako da se tkanina može tkati u Englesku.
They captured Africans to work as slaves on the cotton plantations in the United States.
Porobljavali su Afrikance kako bi radili na takvim plantažama za uzgoj pamuka.
They forced us to grow cotton and grow indigo, which is the blue dye, for the mills.
Bili smo prisiljeni proizvoditi pamuk i indigo za tkanje u Engleskoj.
And these are things you will never have heard. But they cut off the thumbs of the weavers. But when you weave, you have to throw a shuttle like that. So your thumb is the most important part. They cut off the thumbs of the master weavers, so they couldn't teach others how to weave.
Tkaljama su rezali palčeve kako ne bi mogle dalje prenositi svoje znanje i kako ne bi mogle tkati. Svi koji ste pokušali raditi na tkalačkom stanu, znate da je palac ključan za tkanje.
And Gandhi said, as long as we grow raw material, send it far away, then buy the clothing, we will stay slaves.
Gandhi je rekao, dokle god proizvodimo materijale koje zatim se šalju u inozemstvo, a od njih kupujemo gotovi proizvod, uvijek ćemo biti robovi.
And so we must make our own cloth.
I znači, moramo početi proizvoditi svoju tkaninu.
Nobody knew how to spin anymore.
Više nitko nije znao tkati.
He found an 80-year-old woman to teach him how to spin.
Našao jednu ženu staru 80 godina koja ga je naučila tkati.
Then he taught others how to spin.
A zatim je on učio ostalo.
He made the spinning wheel the symbol of our freedom.
On je
Preslica,
da, predenje, to je postalo simbolom našeg pokreta.
And when people laughed at him and said, how do you think the small pieces of wood can bring you freedom? He said, it's the only thing that can.
Ljudi su ga smijavali, pitali ga, kako misliš da će taj mali komad drva koji koristiš osloboditi tvoj narod? Međutim, on je odgovorio, to je jedino što nas se može osloboditi.
And he said, it's only when this little spinning wheel is in the hands of the poorest and most marginalized women, and she can spin cloth in her own little hut, then millions can become free. That is our power.
Naša snaga leži u tome da kad je najsiromašnija žena može kod kuće tkati platno, to će donijeti, osloboditi milione. U tome je naša snaga.
But of course he also said, don't use British cloth. Make your own cloth. So he led boycotts.
Naravno, vodio je bojkot protiv britanske tkanine. Rekao je, nemojte kupovati njihovu tkaninu, kupujte našu.
So when I heard these poison companies now talking of owning the seed, I got inspiration from Gandhi's spinning wheel and said they want us to forget that seed is the source of life, that each of us can save seed, each of us can grow food. We are not going to forget.
Saznala za te proizvođače kemikalija koje žele privatizirati sjeme, sjetila sam se povijesti i Gandijevog puta i to me nadahnulo da započnem sa sakupljanjem sjemenja, a to možemo svi učiniti.
And the other aspect of our movement is to refuse to see seed as someone's property for which they can charge royalty. It is the commons, it belongs to us all.
Drugi aspekt naše borbe je ono protiv čega se borimo, da se sjeme smatra nečim vlasništvom na kojoj će zaraditi profit. Sjeme pripada svima, ono ne može biti privatno.
With the old communist parties of India, we're not doing too well these days. They've lost a lot of elections.
Surađivala sam i sa starom komunističkom partijom Indije. Sada trenutno baš nisu osobito uspješni, izgubili su na izborima.
I said there's only one communism, the commons of the earth. That is true communism.
Za mene postoji samo jedan komunizam, a to je to zajedničko komunalno vlasništvo zemlje.
And the commons of the earth, and the commons of the earth is different from the old style of centralized power in the hands of the state.
A to zajedničko vlasništvo zemlje se razlikuje od nekada centralizirane moći kada je zemlja imala svu moć, kada je vlada imala svu moć.
It's the recognition that every seed is its own source of power.
Svako sjeme zapravo je izvor svoje vlastite moći.
Every person is their own source of power.
Svaka osoba izvor je svoje vlastite moći.
And that power is what we have to unleash.
I upravo tu snagu mi moramo osloboditi.
Because we started to save seeds in 87 and we've created 120 community seed banks for seed as a commons to be exchanged, we've been able to respond to many kinds of disasters.
Budući da smo od 1987. godine počeli sakupljati sjemenje i osnovali 120 zajednica za međusobnu razmjenu sjemenja, uspjeli smo se odupriti različitim katastrofama.
One is an economic disaster. You recognize it in one way, our farmers are recognizing it in a very tragic way.
To se odnosi i na ekonomsku krizu. Vi ju doživljavate na jedan način, naši poljoprivrednici na posve drugačiji i tragičan način.
So our cotton farmers, India is where cotton originated, Gandhi spun freedom through cotton. In 1998, Monsanto, which is now the biggest company in the world controlling seed, and they tried to buy up last week the second biggest company, Syngenta.
Monsanto je pokušao, koji je postao 1998. godine, kupiti drugog najvećeg vlasnika.
The second biggest seed chemical company, Syngenta. They've tried.
Aha, drugu najsnažniju tvornicu proizvođača kemikalija, Syngenta.
Monsanto came into India illegally, without obeying the law, in 1998. And I know they're trying very hard to get into Eastern Europe in all kinds of illegal ways.
I znam da na isti način, nezakoniti način, nastoje prodirati na tržište Istočne Evrope.
But because I had participated in writing the international law and our national laws, I immediately checked whether they had taken approval, and they had not.
Budući sam sudjelovala u oblikovanju kako međunarodnog, tako i našeg lokalnog indijskog zakona, odmah sam odlučila provjeriti imaju li dozvolu, i nemaju.
So I sued them in the Indian Supreme Court.
Tužila sam ih na Vrhovnom sudu.
They were stopped for about 6 years.
Njihovo djelovanje zaustavljeno je na 6 godina.
But there's only 2 ways in which these giant corporations do business.
Međutim, takve ogromne korporacije poslovne posluju samo na 2 načina.
First is to steal that which belongs to people.
Prvo je krađom onoga što pripada ljudima, narodu.
And the second is to corrupt governments to help them steal.
A drugi način je korupcija vlade koja im pomaže da kradu.
So they eventually got the approvals through all kinds of measures.
Tako da su na kraju dobili odobrenja za brojne mjere koje provode.
And within 5 years, they started to control 95% of the cotton seed in India.
Bilo mi potrebno 5 godina da uspiju kontrolirati 95% sjemena pamuka u Indiji.
Which is this BT cotton which produces poison in the plant itself.
Dakle, radi se o tom pamuku koji u samoj biljci sadrži već otrov.
And if you want to understand how much profit they make, the price of cotton seed before Monsanto was 5 rupees for a kilogram of seed.
Ukoliko želite dobiti sliku o tome koliko zarađuju prije dolaska Monsanta, kilogram sjemena pamuka stajao je 5 rupija.
They took it to 4,000.
Sada je cijena 4,000.
That's more than 70,000% increase.
Više od 70,000%.
Did Indian farmers suddenly have 70,000% more money? No.
Jesu li možda poljoprivrednici odjednom došli do takvog bogatstva? Ne, nisu.
They make them sign on a little piece of paper and give the seed on credit.
Prisiljavaju ih na neki način da potpisuju i sjeme, da potpisom sjeme dobiju na kredit.
And within 2-3 years the farmers can't pay, they're in debt. And then they come and say, the agents of the company come and say, your land now belongs to me because you didn't pay the debt.
Za 2-3 godine poljoprivrednici se nađu u dugu koju više ne mogu podmiriti i tada predstavnici tvrtke dođu i kažu, radi vašeg duga, vaša zemlja sad pripada nama.
And then the farmer goes to the field and ends his life drinking pesticide.
I događa se često da tada poljoprivrednici odluče okončati svoj život tako da odu u polje i otruju se pesticidima.
The number of suicides in India among farmers from 95 when this new global order started to today is more than 300,000.
Od 95. kada započeo taj novi globalni ustroj do sada ubilo se oko 300,000 poljoprivrednika.
And I think it's unacceptable that even one life be taken for one company's profit.
Ja držim da je neprihvatljivo izgubiti jedan jedini život u svrhu ostvarivanja profita.
That is why we save seeds.
I radi toga sakupljamo i čuvamo sjeme.
So we started to save cotton seeds. I didn't. I used to save food crops, and we started to save cotton seeds.
Počeli smo tako čuvati i sakupljati sjemenje pamuka.
We started to work with farmers to help them grow organic with their own seed.
Pružili smo pomoć poljoprivrednicima da organski uzgajaju i da siju svoje vlastito sjeme.
Farmers using their own seed and doing organic farming are earning 10 times more than those trapped by Monsanto.
Poljoprivrednici koji organski uzgajaju i siju svoje vlastito sjeme zarađuju 10 puta više od onih koji su zarobljeni u ovom sustavu koji smo ranije opisali.
Now that same monoculture of the mind is used to say, if you only grow cotton, there'll be more cotton. Of course there'll be more cotton.
Ista ta monokultura uma tumači, ako uzgajamo samo i puno pamuka, imat ćemo jako puno pamuka, pa naravno.
But you're not growing your food, you're not growing your cereals, you're not growing your beans, you're not growing your vegetables.
Međutim, tada nema prostora, ne uzgajate hranu koja vam je potrebna, žitarice, mahunarke, povrće.
So what we say is, don't measure the monoculture, measure the diversity.
Ono što mi predlažemo je, nemojte mjeriti monokulturu, nego mjerite raznolikost.
And there are two new indicators we have evolved. One, because food is supposed to be about our health and nourishment. We say, let's measure the nutrition that we grow on an acre of land. Not the profits for Monsanto.
Zato što dobra hrana nas čini zdravima, predložili smo da mjerimo hranjivost biljaka koje uzgajamo, a ne da mjerimo postotak dobiti Monsanto.
We call this health per acre.
To nazivamo zdravlje po jutru zemlji.
And having saved the seeds and having grown the biodiversity, we've then measured farm by farm how much nutrition we are growing.
I tako smo poljoprivredno dobro po poljoprivredno dobro mjerili pomoću te raznovrsnosti koje su uzgajali hranjivost bilja na svakom poljoprivrednom dobru.
If all the land that is today under agriculture grew diversity with our own seeds through seed sovereignty, we could feed two Indias.
Kad bi svi na taj način uzgajali bioraznovrsnost da poštuju i svoje sjeme da koriste, mogu bi se proizvoditi dovoljno hrane za dvije Indije.
And then we said, okay, they keep talking money all the time, you know. They take away everything we have and then say, you don't have money. No, you took our land, you took our seeds, you took our jobs, you took our factories. But you're even stealing the finances.
Zatim nam spočitavaju da nemamo novca. Ukrali su nam zemlju, ukrali su nam posao, ukrali su nam sjemenje i sada žele ukrasti i naš novac.
So we said, let's measure the true cost of this industrial agriculture. What is the real cost?
Zato smo rekli, idemo izmjeriti prave troškove industrijske proizvodnje.
And we call that wealth per acre.
To nazivamo bogatstvo po jutru zemlje.
Most people don't remember that the word wealth comes from well-being, being well.
Mnogi ljudi su zaboravili da riječ bogatstvo dolazi od riječi biti dobro. Kako mi nešto slično?
Dobro
biti. Da, kod nas to nije slično. It's not the case in English. It's not the same.
No, it's not. The English word. After all, it's the English word is thrown around at us.
I onako nas osipavaju engleskim riječima.
In no local language does the word money mean wealth. No local language.
Ni u jednom lokalnom jeziku riječ novac nije ista kao riječ bogatstvo.
Only English.
S
because the language of the exploiters of the British in the past and now the US is English. So they mess around with our words and they mess around with our brains.
Oni se igraju sa riječima, tako isto se igraju s našim mozgom.
So they take a word which meant being well, being healthy, being happy, and turn it into money.
I riječ koju smo koristili za biti sretan, biti dobroga stanja, dobroga zdravlja, koriste za riječ sada da ima značenje novca.
And then they turn that into GDP, gross domestic product.
A zatim se to pretvorilo u BDP.
And they never told you that when they measure GDP, they're basically measuring how the oligarchs stole faster.
Ono što računa, što se računa u BDP-u je način na koji oligarsi sve brže kradu.
There's a new study out from Oxfam which shows that 80 billionaires, 80 rich men in the world control as much wealth as 3.5 billion people, that's half of humanity.
Oxfam je nedavno objavio da 80 najbogatijih ljudi na svijetu kontrolira bogatstvo u vrijednosti od 3,5 milijarde ljudi, dakle pola čovječanstva.
Now if this... And these 80 oligarchs, their wealth is then divided by the 3.5 to say everyone's growing.
Zato bi bogatstvo tih 80 oligarha se podijeli sa 3,5 milijarde ljudi i prikaže se kao pa svi imaju bogatstvo u porastu.
And if this process of exploitation continues, within a few years they will control the wealth of 99% of humanity. 99%.
Ukoliko se ova eksploatacija nastavi za nekoliko godina, na ovaj način kontrolirat će 99% čovječanstva.
So your town, which had industry, which had work, has been devastated, but this is going to happen to every village, every town, everywhere.
Vaš grad, koji nekada bio industrijski grad, je uništen, međutim to će se dogoditi posvud.
That's why we have to create another kind of economy.
Zato moramo stvoriti novu vrstu ekonomije.
The companies won't create it because they benefit from this.
Naravno, tvrtke ne žele u tome sudjelovati jer one ostvaruju tržišnog stanja.
The corrupt politicians who help their oligarch friends, and very often they are the oligarchs themselves, they are not going to define a new economy because they've done so well.
Korumpirani političari koji su prijatelji oligarha, a često su i sami oligarsi, svakako neće novu ekonomiju potaknuti.
So people have to create this new economy.
Ljudi je moraju stvoriti. Ljudi moraju stvoriti novu ekonomiju.
For two reasons.
Iz dva razloga.
First, it's a better economy.
Prvo, zato što je to bolja ekonomija.
It's better for the earth.
Bolja za zemlju.
And it's better for people.
I bolja za ljudi.
The word economy comes from the Greek root oikos.
Riječ ekonomija dolazi od grčke riječi oikos.
Ecology also comes from the same root oikos.
Kao i riječ ekologija koja dolazi iz istog korijena.
Ecology is the knowledge and science of how this planet works and our homes work and our communities work.
Ekologija je znanost koja se bavi time kako živi ovaj planet, kako živimo s ljudi.
Economy is supposed to be the management on the basis of that knowledge.
Ekonomija bi trebalo biti upravljanje utemeljeno na tom znanju, na tim spoznanjama.
Today's economy is not an economy in that sense of taking care of our home.
Današnja ekonomija nije ekonomija u tom smislu da brine za naš dom, kao što je mišljeno.
Aristotle discriminated, defined ekonomija as the art of living, ability to live.
za Aristotela ekonomija je bila mogućnost, sposobnost života, življenja.
And he called what is called the economy today krematistics, the art of making money, and I would add the art of making money by stealing from nature and society.
Ono što za danas nazivamo ekonomijom, on je nazivao umjetnošću stvaranja novca, a ja bih dodala krađom od
nature and society.
Krađom od društva i od prirode.
I have left this new manifesto we've written with Irina to translate into Croatian so that you all can have access to it.
Ostavila sam ovaj naš novi manifest kod Irene da bude da prevedete na hrvatski kako bi vam svima bio dostupan.
It's called Terra Viva, Our Soil, Our Commons, Our Future.
Zove se Terra Viva, naša zemlja, naša budućnost.
And what we've shown in it is the current economy is based on extraction. You exploit nature and you exploit society. And this extraction leads to accumulation of wealth, and those 80 billionaires get rich.
Sadašnja, današnja ekonomija utemeljena je na eksploataciji, a to je zatim postaje, dakle, izvlači se iz zemlje i od ljudi, i to postaje bogatstvo onih 80 najbogatijih ljudi, muškaraca.
We've to move to a circular economy.
Mi želimo tu ekonomiju pretvoriti u ovakvu kružnu ekonomiju.
Now when we have a circular economy, we give back to nature.
Na taj način vraćamo prirodi ono što nam je dalo.
But we give back within community.
A isto tako i društvu, zajednici.
And when we give back, we actually generate real wealth.
I kada se odužujemo, kada vraćamo, zapravo stvaramo pravo bogatstvo.
Take the seed.
Uzmimo, na primjer, sjeme.
So, you know, there are about 100 seeds in this package.
Tu je možda stotinu komada graha.
Each of them will give me another 100 seeds.
I svako od njih, od svakog od njih, dobit ću još stotinu.
This is an economy of abundance.
Ovo je ekonomija obilja.
When I can save it, grow it, eat part of it, share part of it.
Kada mogu nešto sakupiti, uzgojiti, dio podijeliti s ostalima, a dio zadržati za sebe.
There's no scarcity.
Ovdje nema nedostatka.
Scarcity is created when a company like Monsanto says, that seed is mine.
Nema nezadovoljene potrebe za hranom koja se stvara kad Monsanto kaže ovo sjeme pripada meni.
When you use it, you have to pay me a royalty.
Jer kad ga koristite, morate platiti nama profit.
And you can't save it next year.
I ne možete ga sačuvati za sljedeću godinu.
And even if the royalty is at the cost of your life, which is what's happening to Indian farmers, we will still continue to extract.
Iako će možda taj profit koji mi zarađujemo biti utemeljen na oduzimanju života, mi ćemo i dalje to nastaviti raditi.
Now, because we started to save seeds 30 years ago, and the seed saving movement has grown everywhere, their dream of making every seed genetically engineered and patented did not work.
Zato što već 30 godina sakupljamo sjemenje, po cijelom svijetu i taj proces je sve širi, uključeno je sve više ljudi, oni sanjaju o tome da svako sjeme bude patentirano.
So they then started trying a new trick.
Međutim, to im nije uspjelo i sad pokušavaju sa jednim novim trikom.
They started to get laws passed to say, you can't save your own seeds because they are primitive.
Pokušavaju i uspijevaju da se donose zakoni kojima se zabranjuje korištenje vlastitog sjemena, jer ono je primitivno.
They tried it in India in 2004, and again I took a very Gandhian action to force that law to roll back.
Pokušali su u Indiji to 2004. godine, međutim ja sam nastupila na gandijevski, organizirala akciju na gandijevski način i taj zakon je povučen.
Because Gandhi, besides teaching us that we can make our own cloth and through that get freedom, he also taught us that unjust laws should not be obeyed.
Gandhi nas nije samo naučio da tako što ćemo tkati svoje tkanine ćemo ostvariti. Nepravednim zakonima, nepravedne zakone ne moramo poštivati.
When the British tried to make So you know the British when they were ruling us they said, "Oh, these Indians eat a lot of salt. We have to anyway in a hot climate. You sweat a lot, you lose a lot of salt, you've got to eat a lot of salt."
Kad su bili engleska kolonija, Britanci su primijetili, ovi Indijci jedu jako puno soli. To nam je potrebno jer živimo u vrlo toploj klimi i sol moramo uzimati.
So they said, we would make it illegal for Indians to make salt.
Zato su rekli, učinit ćemo indijsku proizvodnju soli van zakona.
It'll be our monopoly, only we can make salt. They'd have not made a lot of money if they'd made salt their monopoly. Like Monsanto makes some money, a lot of money wherever they've monopolized the seed. So Gandhi walked to the beach. He picked up the salt from the seawater.
Zagrabio je morske vode i soli.
He said, "Nature gives it for free. We need it for our survival. We will continue to make salt. We will not obey your laws."
I tada je Gandhi rekao, priroda nam ništa ne plaća za sol, ona je besplatna, potrebna nam je za naše zdravlje i zato nećemo poštivati vaš zakon, nastavit ćemo sami proizvoditi.
So when they tried to make our seeds illegal, we did the same with seed. We said, we've received these seeds from nature and our ancestors and our grandmothers.
Isto smo učinili kada su to pokušali napraviti sa našim sjemenom. Nismo poštivali taj zakon, nismo naš sjemenje dobili iz prirode i od naših predaka.
We will continue to save our seeds, make our seeds, exchange our seeds.
Nastavit ćemo čuvati sjemenje, koristiti ga i razmjenjivati.
We will not obey laws that criminalize the seed and our actions.
Nećemo poštivati zakone koje smatraju kriminalom naše sjemenje i našu djelatnost.
Because the laws written by corporations are unacceptable to us.
Zato što su nama posve neprihvatljivi zakoni koje pišu korporacije.
The laws written by nature, that seed multiplies and renews. The laws written by humanity and our human rights, those are the high laws we will obey.
Ovi najviše zakone koje ćemo poštivati su zakoni prirode, da sjeme raste samo, da se razmnožava, to ćemo poštivati.
So they could never pass the law in India.
Tako da nikad nećemo uspjeti provesti takav zakon u Indiji.
They tried in Europe. Last year and through the big seed freedom movement we've created, we have that rollback.
Pokušali su prošle godine takav zakon donijeti u Europi, međutim pomoću našeg pokreta zaštite sjemena nije to uspjelo.
So now they're going after their own seed savers in the United States.
I sada su se okrenuli protiv ljudi koji čuvaju svoje sjemenje u Sjedinjenim Američkim Državama.
They're telling small seed savers, if you grow local seed, it's agri-terrorism.
Kažu malim poljoprivrednicima koji čuvaju svoje sjeme, ukoliko sijete vaše sjeme, to je agri-terrorism.
So we are going to go back to the US and tell them how they fought racism, how Martin Luther King took Gandhi's lessons, and said we will not obey unjust racist laws, we're going to remind them that humanity always has the freedom to not subject themselves to injustice.
Podsjetiti ljude kako su se borili protiv rasizma, kako je Martin Luther King učio od Gandija i kako je naše pravo ne podlijegati nepravednim zakonima.
And my trip here to Croatia I want it to be the beginning of a really strong solidarity for the defense of the earth and defense of our rights.
Nadam se da će moj posjet Hrvatskoj biti početak snažnog jednog pokreta očuvanja prava raznovrsnosti i prirode.
I hope some of you will be able to come for a one-month course in which we do seed saving and soil and everything about how to work with the earth and produce prosperity and how to resist the destruction. In September, from 1st to 30th, and we talk, and we would love to have a team from this part of the world so that you can really accelerate your movement.
Bilo bi nam jako drago da netko od vas, da skupina vas dođe na naš jednomjesečni tečaj od 1. do 30. rujna, gdje učimo sve o čuvanju, uzgoju, pohranjivanju sjemena. I nadamo se da će to dati jedan snažan impuls ovu pokretu.
And this year, because it's the year of soil, and we will leave a few flyers with you about the fortnight of action we celebrate for seed freedom and soil and our joint freedom with the earth. This year, for the year of soil, I'm organizing a pilgrimage to where the farmers are committing suicide, but also where Gandhi started his mission.
Ova godina zemlja je tla, godina je tla, i ostavit ćemo naše brošure. Organiziram hodočašće na mjesta gdje su poljoprivrednici najviše počinili samoubojstva, gdje je također ubijen Gandhi.
I want to conclude with a poem from Palestine that has been my inspiration from the beginning.
Željela bih zaključiti ovaj skup sa pjesmom koja me je nadahnula, pjesmom iz Pakistana.
Palestine. And it basically says, you can destroy everything that we have.
Njezina bit je da možete uništiti sve što imamo.
But I don't despair.
Ali ja ne očajam.
You can kill the trees and bomb our homes. I don't give up.
Možete postići sva stabla, uništiti naše domove, ali ja neću odustati.
Because I have one seed that I will save and plant and grow back my life.
Jer imam jedno sjeme.
Saving seeds and trying to do something ecologically and to make it better. And regarding European Union and the situation politically, economically, and this, what people would like to do, what would your advice be to people trying to make a change. Možda in this part of the world.
Možda da prevedem za ljude koji nisu razumjeli, dolazim iz Slovenije sa skupinom istomišljenika koji ekološki uzgajaju hranu. Postavila bih vam pitanje kako da nastavimo, kako da radimo u ovom okruženju i u kontekstu Europske unije. Jako sam to spratila.
Yeah. First I want to say that, you know, for someone like me who grew up with Yugoslavia as such a close friend of India, I still get puzzled by the many names of many countries. And that's why it's so important to realize there's only one country we have, which is the Earth.
Zato je najvažnije upamtiti da imamo samo jednu zemlju gdje obitavamo, a to je zemlja, planet Zemlja.
And it's the seed that can unite us.
A sjeme nas može ujediniti.
So I would say first, because the European Union will try its best, as they did with Ukraine, to push GMOs. Even though European Union is GMO free, they push it on Eastern Europe.
Mislim da će se dogoditi kao što se dogodilo sa Ukrajinom, iako je Europa slobodna, iako je u Europi zabranjen GMO, oni će ga nastojati potisnuti u istočnu Europu.
Don't allow GMOs to enter your societies.
Nemojte dozvoliti da u vaše društvo, u vaše zajednice uđe GMO.
And that means working at every level to say no to GMOs.
I to na svim razinama u društvu treba provesti.
Because a GMO isn't a thing.
Jer GMO nije stvar.
It's a relationship of power.
To je jedna veza među onima koji imaju vlast.
It's a symbol of slavery and exploitation.
I simbol je služanstva i eksploatacije.
That's why we have to save the seeds of freedom.
Zato moramo čuvati sjemenje za našu slobodu.
The second thing that really is important is for the seed saving to get linked as the foundation of other economies around food.
I ono što je bitno za čuvanje sjemena je povezati se sa ostalim aspektima ekonomije vezanim uz hranu.
Because everyone must eat.
Svi moraju jesti.
And the better food comes from local and organic.
Dobra hrana dolazi iz lokalne sredine, organski uzgojena hrana.
There's a very interesting video that's gone viral. 2 million people have looked at it. It's 2 minutes of a Swedish family which ate organic for 2 weeks only and all the pesticides in their body disappeared.
Jedan video koji je imao, čini mi se, 2 milijarde pogleda.
2 million people watch the video.
Dakle, 2 miliona ljudi je pogledalo taj 2-minutni video, gdje se vidi da je tijekom 2 tjedna jedna švedska obitelj posve očistila svoje tijelo od pesticida jedući organsku uzgojenu hranu.
So we have to see good food as an ecological issue, as a health issue, an issue of our freedom and democracy.
Dobra, zdrava hrana je problematika, dakle, i zdravlja, i ekologije, i demokracije.
And the third is this, on the Seed Freedom website, you will find more details about these actions we do locally, but we connect internationally.
Više ćete i na web stranici našoj naučiti o tome kako djelujemo i lokalno, ali i na međunarodnoj razini.
So through local expression of action, we really make a difference.
Kroz aktivnost na lokalnoj razini, doista doprinosimo pokretu.
And through international relationship, we realize we are part of one movement.
A kroz naše veze na međunarodnoj razini, osvještavamo to da smo svi dijelovi istog pokreta.
And what we are creating is the only thing that will give a future.
I ono što stvaramo je jedino ono koje će nam omogućiti dobru budućnost.
Never underestimate the power of one seed.
Nemojmo nikada podcijeniti snagu sjemena.
Never underestimate the power of your actions.
I nikada nemojte podcijeniti moć i snagu vašeg djelovanja.
And Eastern Europe, I can see Eastern Europe showing another way. It moved from communism to capitalism, but there's another way.
Vidim u istočnoj Europi da će istočna Europa pokazati novi put. Prošla je razdoblje prelaska iz komunizma u kapitalizam, ali pokazat će nam i novi put.
We call it earth democracy.
Nazivamo to demokracijom zemlje.
Not market democracy.
Ne tržišna demokracija.
Not the freedom of the oligarchs.
Svakog društva, svake zajednice.
And we are there to walk with you.
I mi smo tu da se pridružimo na tom putu, da vam se pridružimo na tom putu.
My answer's over, but you know, I think there's a dinner we should be moving, because we were late coming here. So we'll be late getting back to
that. Zakasnili smo do vas, a zakasnit ćemo i na naš sljedeći dogovor.
Ne biste vjerovali, ali ima i dalje. Zagrebu, da što ne more ići, ja ne. Mislim da smo
najstavljeni. Ne, ovo ići
tam. Yeah, I'm an Irish hand, so it's all right. If she gives permission, we have permission.
Evo dozvolite.
Policajca protokola je dozvolila.
I'm Nada Tushak, I'm the president of Živizid. It's a political party, Živizid Sisak, and we support food sovereignty. And my question is about urban agriculture. Do you support urban agriculture? Is there any possibility, you think actually, is there any possibility to grow food in towns, in cities?
Moje pitanje odnosi se na urbanu poljoprivredu i što o tome mislite, odobravate?
Yes, for sure. Wherever the sun shines and you can put a little soil and put a little seed, you can grow food.
Naravno, gdje god sunce sije, god ima malo zemlje, možete posijati sjeme.
And we call this movement the Gardens of Hope.
Ovaj pokret nazivamo Vrtovima nade.
We've started it with the widows who lost everything.
Započeli smo sa udovicama koje su sve izgubile.
But we do it with schools in the cities.
Ali u gradovima to radimo sa školama.
So our children don't forget.
Tako da naša djeca ne zaboravaju.
That they're part of the earth.
Da su dijelom zemlje.
That working with the soil is the highest vocation a human being can have.
Da je najveći poziv, najviša vokacija čovjekova raditi sa zemljom.
And when I've talked to them, they've always said, as I asked, so what touched you most? I said, the fact that one seed gave us 1,000 tomatoes and lots of seed.
Kad pitam djecu što te se najviše dojmilo, oni uvijek kažu, ta činjenica da od jednog sjemena smo dobili 1000 paradajza i još sjemena.
My question is, I guess that on your path, these mighty corporations were trying to do nasty things to you.
Yeah.
So my question is, can you tell us the nastiest story of this thing, of your voyage?
Because of my voyage.
I guess that your role is to be let's say we had in the Second World War partisans. These men were ready to risk their lives and live in the woods for a few years to defeat fascists. So I guess that your role is very much the same, because there are not so many of people of you. I just want you to tell us the nastiest story.
Well, you know, I do call the system that's being created food fascism.
Znate, ja sustav nazivam fašizmom hrane.
And I definitely participate in a resistance movement. But it's a resistance both through creative action and no to injustice.
Ali to je istovremeno kreativno djelovanje i odbijanje nepravde.
And personally for me it's a refusal to become afraid.
A ja osobno odbijam se bojati.
Or to be silenced.
Ili...
I won't bore you with the details. It's not significant.
I would like to say just hello to all of you as one of the organizers of this event. And after this strong and powerful lecture, I really have nothing special to say, except to invite you to the part of the program that we have tomorrow. And this is actually what we planned to work together and to create all these changes, to put our ideas together and to see how we are going to work together, as Dr. Shiva just actually advised us. So this part of work tomorrow, we'll start with a presentation of the Year of Soil, and also with the other things that we are facing today. But the most of the day will be actually for you, for your ideas to take place and to see how we are going to implement them, because it is very important to put that really in practice. And also, actually, I'd like to...
Pozivam vas na nastavak programa. Sutra je program posvećen vama. Započenjamo sa prezentacijom.
Znači, sutrašnji dio programa namijenili smo upravo vama, jer nakon ovakvog snažnog predavanja ja stvarno nemam što puno dodati, nego vas pozvati da sutra stavimo zajedno glave i sve te ideje koje ste dobili i svu tu motivaciju pretvorimo u konkretne akcije, da zajedno vidimo kako ćemo organizirati na svoj način obilježiti i pridružiti se ovoj akciji koja je u 9. mjesecu i da jednostavno pokušamo zajedno nešto napraviti. Zahvaljujem se svima puno. Evo, ovo su ti.